This is Rebecca from chemistryismyjam.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at units and the metric system. So let's begin with types of units. In science, we use the International System of Units, which are often called SI units. It's important that scientists use a consistent set of units worldwide so that they can collaborate on projects together. According to the SI units, the unit for length is the meter. The unit for mass is the gram, volume uses the liter, time is measured in seconds, and temperature is measured in Kelvin. Kelvin, as a temperature scale, is new to many chemistry students. So let's talk about where these temperature scales that we use in chemistry come from. We're going to begin with the Celsius scale. The Celsius scale is based off of water. Scientists said, water freezes at this temperature, we're going to call that zero. Water boils at this temperature, we're going to call that 100. And everything else was incremented in between. So the Celsius scale is based off of water. There is a low point on the temperature scale, and we call it absolute zero. Absolute zero is the coldest that you can possibly get. The reason for that is that temperature is based off of the motion of particles. If you've got particles in motion and they start speeding up, temperature raises. If they start slowing down, temperature starts falling back down. So you have a point where all motion stops. That is absolute zero. So the lowest point on the temperature scale is the point where all motion stops. And for Celsius, that is negative 273 degrees Celsius. So you have this large negative range on the Celsius temperature scale. Well, that can be a little bit problematic when you start doing math with temperatures because all of a sudden you've got negative numbers involved. So it's handy to use a temperature scale that doesn't have any negative numbers. The Kelvin scale takes the Celsius scale and shifts it by 273 degrees so that all of a sudden, zero is absolute zero, 273 is the freezing point of water, and 373 is the boiling point of water. The increments on the Kelvin scale are the same as the increments on the Celsius scale, but the scale has been shifted up by 273 degrees so that there are no negative numbers, which is quite handy if you have to do math with those temperature values. Let's talk some more about some of these other units that we see in the International System of Units. These units, like meter and gram and liter, are considered the base units for the metric system. The metric system is based off of factors of 10. You have base units where there is not a prefix present, like the gram and the meter. And then you have prefixes that indicate the factor of 10 that your number has been shifted by. So why does the metric system have these prefixes? Well, it has to do with the size of whatever it is you're measuring. If you're measuring a room, then the meter, which is a base unit, is a very appropriate length of measurement. However, if you were trying to measure a city, then the meter would give you a really obnoxious number. So you would want to use something more like the kilometer, where the number has been shifted by a factor of 10 to the third, so that you have a much more reasonable number in your measurement. So your base units don't have a prefix, for example, the gram, the meter, the liter. But when you put a prefix on the front of those, you're telling whoever's reading your measurement by what factor of 10 you've shifted that number by. The prefixes that are the most common are kilo, which is shifted by 10 to the third, hecto is shifted by 10 to the second, deca is shifted by 10, and then you have deci, which is shifted by 10 to the negative 1, centi by 10 to the negative 2, and milli, which is shifted by 10 to the negative 3. Now in chemistry, we're often counting things like atoms, which are really, really small. And so sometimes we end up using things like nano or micro. So there are other prefixes that are outside of the ones that you see here, but these are the most common in the metric system. Let's now go take a look at a metric conversion where we'll shift between a base and some of the prefixes that you see here. In this example, we're going to convert 5.28 millimeters to kilometers. So we're going from one end of the scale all the way to the other end of the scale. You always want to start with the number and the unit that you're given in the question. So you can see here that I've started with 5.28 millimeters. Then I'm going to set up a conversion factor here where I'm going to put whatever unit I started with here on the bottom of this conversion factor. So I had millimeters to begin with. I need millimeters to be on the bottom of this factor. And I'm converting from millimeters, which has a prefix, to a base. I'm going to meters, which does not have a prefix. The conversion factor is 10 to the negative third, which was the definition of millimeter that we saw on the previous screen. So for every 1 millimeter, there's 10 to the negative third meters. If I were to stop the calculation right now, millimeters would cancel, and I would have my answer in meters. But I want kilometers, so I'm going to go another step. So whenever I set up a new fraction, whatever unit I have at the top of the previous fraction is going on the bottom of my current fraction. That way, that unit will cancel. So I had meters here, I've put meters here, and I want to go from meters to kilometers. The conversion factor to go from meters to kilometers is 10 to the third. So there's 10 to the third meters for every 1 kilometer. When you are set up like this, you want to multiply by all the numbers on the top and then divide by all the numbers at the bottom. If you will follow that pattern where whatever unit you have here goes on the bottom of the next fraction, then all of these will cancel. Everything that I have here in pink has canceled, leaving me with kilometers. So my answer would be 5.28 times 10 to the negative 6th kilometers. That wraps up our brief review of the metric system. Stick around as we begin discussing scientific notation and how it relates to measurement.